Cooling in the stream. Little fish nibble our toes. The laughter of love. Yeah. I want to mention that I'm coming to New York October 1st to the 15th. I'll be seeing private clients in the city and having a seminar workshop all day on October the 8th. There's more information on the website. Please take a look. And if you're in New York or coming to New York, I'd love to see you. So we come to the I Ching. That vital information that comes to us through the ancient oracle and takes us to a place of love and a place of light and a place where we can remember just who we are. The I Ching. For the week of August 30th, 2016. Number 46, Sheng ascending. Above is Kun, the sun of the earth. Below is Sun, the foundation. The wisdom, you're in a time of ascension. That's what you're feeling. What you've been working for is beginning to show. It's vital now to be present, to be mindful of where you stand. This is your season of harvesting. Your harvest in this case consists of the ripe fruits of small and steady efforts. You've been paying attention to all the details. You've been remaining steadfast as you can to the principles of working for the greater good. And until now, it seemed as if the fruits of your efforts have been elusive. Be without expectation now. In your present situation, your expectations are about to be humbled by the good fortune that is coming your way. The energy and ideas that have been elusive no longer are. All possibilities are available to you now. Do not sit back and await for the genie to come out of the lantern as you rub it, waiting for it to grant your wishes. It's time to be very active, to seize your dreams when you see them. This is a short window we have, so it's time to be active, proactive. Summoning your self-worth is the benefit now. If you do not believe you're worthy of your dreams, they'll pass you by and leave you grasping at the wind. Repeat the inner mantra, I am good enough. Yeah, try it. I am good enough. As you make your move toward the benefits you've desired and dreamed. That's a good mantra as you walk the beach, you walk the city streets, you walk the mountain roads. I am good enough with each step, and you'll feel it in your body. In the recent past, try yesterday, it's felt like your waiting period has been interminable. That was your analytical mind, interfering with the universal laws of right timing. Patience and quiet nurturing is what is needed now, whether it's in your relationship to your own inner self or in your projects, to your external relationships, and to your connection with your service to the basic systems of the earth. You must be in touch with that. The earth, you remember her, right? Your mother, your home. This good is happening and there's no need to push it. Find your stillness every day. What you've desired is coming your way. Don't ask when. Just take a look. It's now. Trust and faith is the powerful engine that will propel you forward in your quest for what is right and in harmony with the natural way of being. Quiet your heart and mind and allow the natural way to unfold. Be steady and don't miss a step. Progress and prosperity are assured. All things that you've worked and wished for in life are moving forward. They're moving toward your and toward the greater good. It is as if you're exactly synchronized with the calendar of your life path. The energies of the earth and the universe are moving in harmony with you. They're moving with your actions and your desires. All you need to do is to be still, feel it, and then move with it. Because your intuition is at an extremely high level. You can trust it as you make your well-considered moves, right? Don't rush it, but make your well-considered moves fired by your intuition, whether they're in love, in business, or in the care of our planet and all her beings. Bring all together and be the giver of love and life to your tribe, your family, and your relationships. Note well that while you may harvest the bounty that's available to you now, the benefit will be to return this energy in equal measure to the living organism of Gaia, to which you are deeply rooted. This is your family, which has silently and elegantly supported and nurturing you so that you could get to this point of beneficial harvest. Keep feeding the whole, the oneness of which we are all a part. Fail this, and you fail yourself. That's the truth. Fail this time. Fail your connection to the earth, your connection to community, family, and you fail yourself. Have confidence in the work you've done, that you've correctly nurtured yourself and your relationships and your tribe or your project to this point. Stop beating yourself up that you haven't done it right. That's a useless exercise that would leave you weak and pitiful. Have faith that your growth is assured if you allow everything to unfold without the judgment or the interference of the critical, analytical mind. Refrain from picking things apart and just let the mind relax in its own vast, natural spaciousness. Meditate on a lake, on a mountain stream. This hexagram signifies that your personal magic could not be at a higher or more beneficial point. Your ideas will be well received. Externally, you will advance in your relationships and your career, and your words will be heard. You're part of a network that is connecting all good things for the benefit of yourself, your tribe, and the world community. Stay steady and remain humble. Meditate and take part in the activities that keep you centered and grounded. By adhering to the higher laws, those of compassion and kindness and integrity, what you will gain will remain. Any doubts about yourself will wash away like the dust after a long four spring rain. Yeah. This week, listen to the wind. It'll speak to you. Listen to the waters. They'll teach you. Celebrate fire as it burns away the dross. Taste of the earth herself, right? Taste her vegetables, her fruits. Taste her dirt. It's not dirty. Taste her as she nurtures all sentient beings and wear the air around you like on your skin, like a royal robe of ritual and celebration. Just picture it. Wear the air on your skin like a royal robe of ritual and celebration. Make an offering to Gaia this week in gratitude and humility, and keep in mind that without being of service to our mother, our earth, we are a clanging gong signifying nothing. Yeah. Be love. Teach peace. Be yourself. You're good enough. Be yourself. All right, I'll see you in New York. If you're in Toronto, I'll be there at the end of October. All this information's on the website. I look forward to seeing and meeting you. It's humid here on the 20th parallel. Yeah, we wear the humidity like a kind of a royal robe, but we wear it. Be the love that you wish to be. have the integrity that you wish others had. Treat others with the fairness that you want to be treated with. And give with no thought of return. Be who you are. And let's try the mantra together. I am good enough. Now, together. I am good enough. Huh? I heard you. Much, 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 much love. I will talk to you soon. I'll be talking to you next week. Here on this same channel on the airwaves. It still amazes me that it works like this. You know, I come from a time when fax machines were kind of amazing. But now that we can go out on the internet and talk to so many, it still blows my mind. So let's use this technology for good, for love. Oh yeah, don't forget to dance. Don't forget to dance. In La Keshe a la King. I am the other you. And I like it that way. Yeah. Namaste. Namaste.